Perek Sheni. Habas miyem lidoso ad shetia bas shtei masrishon gmuris hiya nekras ktana v'nekras tinekes. So until the age of 12, she's a ktana and a tinekes. V'afili hivya kamasayres b'tech hazman hazeh is einon ela kishuma. Those sayres are not simonim, they're just kishuma, like some type of a growth, like a wart that has hair. It's those sayres don't make her into a gdela. Aval imi via shtei sayres lemate beguf b'mekemis hayiduis la'avo aseir, which we'll discuss later. V'hi mibas shtei masishon v'yemechad v'mayla. So then is nekras naira. So when she reaches the age of 12 and then she brings sayres, so then that's called naira. Then she becomes a naira. V'avo shtei sayres b'zman hazeh nikra siman hatachten. That's the lower simon. So later on, we're going to learn that there's a musik called the simon elyon, which is not such a simon. It's not such a clear simon. Mashenka simon atachten is an absolute simon. So havash they say Cyrus lemata beguf b'mkemes hayiduis after shishtemas tishon is called the simon atachten, and through that she becomes a naira. Ma'achesh atovi simon atachten tikori naira ad shisha chadoshim gmurim. On the day that the six chadashim end, so then tikori begris. The aim be nairis lebagris el shisha chadashim belvat. So bagris doesn't need any special simonim. 6 months after nairis, she becomes a begris, regardless of when she becomes a naira. She can become a naira on her 12th birthday, as soon as she's 12 years old, and she brings simonim, or she can become a naira later, and still 6 months later, she's a beggar, as we'll learn. Higia l'shtei masrishon av yemechad v'lehi v'yeshtei sayres. Izafo pi sheniru bo simoni aylinis, as we'll soon learn what they are, is adayin ktani ad esim shon, until she's 20 years old, so she cannot become a gdoila. She won't be considered an aylinis until she's esim shon, and we'll learn that it means esim shon apachas ochedish. Abo kshetov yishtei sayres, Afilo b'shnas esim, so then is tia naira shisha chadoshim, v'charkach tikore begros. So b'kitzer, until she's 20, she's a ktana, even if she has simoni eilinus, and if l'peil, she brings sayres before she's declared an eilinus, once she's declared an eilinus, so sayres won't help. Masha'enkin, in the 20th year, when she's only 19, and she's still a ktana, she's not declared a naira, an islandess. So then when she brings Shtei Cyrus, she'll be considered a Naira. And from then on, it'll be that she'll be a Naira for 6 months, and then she'll become a Vegas. Yeah. Nochmal, Kshetov Shtei Cyrus, Afil Bishnas Esim, is Tia Naira Shisha Chadoshim, V'achar Kach Tikori Vegas. Halacha Dalet, Hoysa Bas Esim Shona, Pochus Shleishim Yein, V'lei Hivya Shtei Cyrus, V'niru Bo Simoni Islandess, so then is Harei Islandess. So some have the girsa of nirubo kol simoni aylinus. The Kesef Mishnah says even if the girsa is not kol simoni aylinus, it just says simoni aylinus, but the meaning is kol simoni aylinus. So Kesef Mishnah learned that in order for her to be considered an aylinus, it has to be lehi v'yeshtei sayres and v'nirubo kol simoni aylinus. So then she's declared harehi aylinus. Abavim le nirubo kol simoni aylinus is adayin ktanihi acha tov yeshtei sayres. A at shetia bas chomish shleish mishana v'yemachot. Negiel is manze, v'lehivir shtei sayres, so then is harezu nikras aylinus, avopi sholiniru bas simen misimone aylinus. Is nitzas lomit sha aylinus ein lo yimei nairus, el mikatnusa teitzi labagrus. So, nochamo. So, if a bas that brings simonim, when after she's shtemas rishona, so she's considered a gedela. She's considered a gedela. She doesn't bring simonim. So if by the time she without simonim, she won't be considered a gedela at the very earliest a month before she's 20. If she's a month before she's 20, and she didn't bring any simonim, and she brought kol simoni aylinus, which we'll learn, so then she's considered an aylinus. If, however, she doesn't bring kol simoni aylinus, even though she has mixed simoni aylinus. So she didn't bring Cyrus and she didn't bring Kol Simoni Islandess. So then she becomes an Islandess when she's When she's 35 years old, by the 35th birthday, that's when she becomes an island. And so that's when she's called an islandess, even though she has no simonim from simoni islands. And once she becomes an islandess, goes from katnus to bagras. There's no mitzias of nair in between. There's someone that became a gedola through simonim. So mimela, she becomes a naira, and from the naira, 6 months later, she becomes a beiris. Masha'enken, if she becomes a gedola by becoming an islandess, so she goes straight from katnus to bagras. Not really sure what's the nimtzas lomit. Nimtzas lomit, she islandess, ain't lo yimei nairis, ele mekatnusa teitzel bagras. No, she could become an islandess at 20, or a month before 20, or she become an islandess at 35. Either way, she becomes right away an islandess, a gdela, and a bagras. So a naira becomes through simonim, through an islandess doesn't have simonim, so mela she becomes a gdela, so she becomes a bagras. Halachavav, ve'elu hein simoni islandess, kol she'elu dadim, that there's no development of the dadim, and also miskashe b'shas taishmish, the tashmish is hard for her, it's painful, and ve'ein lo shipulim mi'ayim kenoshim, the normal shipulim mi'ayim the women have, she doesn't have, and ve'keila ova, ve'ein nikeres bin ishli isha. These are the four simonim of islandess, ein lo dadim, miskashe b'shas tashmish, ein lo shipulim mi'ayim, and ve'keila ova. V'hanayra v'habegles v'islandess, kolachas mishloshton, nikras g'deila. They're all g'deilas. A naira is a gdela, a beggar is a gdela, but then there's a different dinam of a naira and a beggar. And the nailandess is also a gdela, and she has the din of a beggar. Halacha zayin. V'yesh bebas, so there's the simon, we spoke about a simon atachten. The simon atachten, if she brings it after she's 12 years old, is a raya, she's a gdela. Now v'yesh bebas simonim no milo, v'hina nikroim simon elyon, and these are also simonim that she's a gdela. That's simonim that she's a gdela, v'elohein. Which shows already on the development of the dat, and also mishiyashchir reisha dat, and also mishiyitin adam yode al uketzadad v'hushikeya v'sheya lachzer, and then mishiyipotzel reish chaytem adad v'yaase bereishi kadur koton. That's one way on Rabbeisa Pirshu that it doesn't mean Yose Bereshi Kadur Kotten, nor Rabbeisa Pirshu Mishiyipotzel HaChetim Atzmi, that it becomes cracks in the Chetim itself of the Dad. V'chein Mishiyatu Hadadim, that's Yatu Hadadim, and it was also that shows on the development of the Dadim, so they're being already Mata, the Tzad Mata, and also Miskashkishu Hadadim, so the Dadim could knock on each other, which also shows on the development of the dadim. Umishetakiv hoa torah, and vahua mokim habosur hatafuach, shelemailim noervelum umes habetn. So when that bosur, which is tafuach, which is a little bit higher, histus, and it becomes like an atorah, mishetakiv hoa torah, so that's also a simon elyon. That's also considered a simon elyon. And also mishiyismayev bosur zeh, so this simon is like the umas of the simon of the islandess. Before, by the simon of the islandess, he said before that one of the simon of the islandess is Eila Shipul Miyayim Kenoshim. And over here, this is like Mishataka Vatore, Vumokim Abbasar Atavosh, Vumailam Nerva. So that's the Shipul Miyayim. And also Mishi Ismail Basar Zev, Liya Kosha, is called Eilu Asimon Mishmena. These are Shmena Simonim of Simon Elyon, of Simon Elyon of Gadus. In other words, they're the Simon Atachten, and there's the Simon Elyon. These are eight Simonim, which is called Simon Elyon, is a Raya of Gadus. Now, Nira Bebas, Simon Mikol Elu Eikulon, Vihi Bashtem Esrei Eipachis, is a Mashgichim Beivarei Bekadnusa. So even though she's in her 12th year, but nevertheless, since just like Simon HaTachten would be nothing before she's actually Shtema Sishon of Yemechot, so al dera zeh Simon HaTachten is avada nothing. However, nasis b'Shtema Sishon of Yemechot v'nira bo Simon HaTachten, so then ein mashgichim bechem b'kolelu. Once she has the Simon HaTachten, so that's an absolute Simon. So then is arei sofik minayra liktana v'donu bo lahachtur. So once she's nira bo echot from this simon elyon, so it becomes a sofik that maybe she already had a simon atachton and it was nesher. There's a sofik that maybe she did have a simon atachton. We don't see it. The answer is because it fell out. V'niru kulam. However, if she had all the simonim ha'elyon, so then the all eight simonim. So then, as a rezuk de levadois, she yevshe she yveu kulam elu kvar bo simon atachton benosha. So in other words, the fact that she has all the simon elyon is a raya that she must have had the simon atachton. We don't see it. The answer is nosha. So nochmo, if she has a simon atachton, so then it's an absolute. She's a gdela. The fact what's going on with the simon elyon is irrelevant. If she has all of the simon elyon, so then we assume that she already also had the simon atachton, and it was nosha, and the hair fell out. And if she only has one of the simon ha'elyon, so then she's a sofik. Maybe she's a ktana, because lepel she doesn't have the simonim. On the other, maybe she's a gdela. How is she a gdela? Because she had the simon ha'elyon, and it was nosha. Yeah. B'chlal, over here, there's like an issue whether or not, when you do the chkira, whether the simonim is a simon or it's a siba. In other words, is the pshat is that the simon is making her a gdela, or the simon is only a simon that she's a gdela, but she's not becoming a gdela through the simonim. She does a lot of the shailas benigeya, the simonim of a behema, a behema teira. Over there, it's the same. The marik, there's a shachuvas marik that clears benigeya the simonim of bagrus, and behem shechlazeh, he clears about the simonim of a behema teira, brings rayas from there. So over here we're saying that if she has all the simoni ha'elyon, so then it's a raya, she must have had the simon atachton and the nosha. L'chura, if all the simoni ha'elyon means that she's a gdela, what's an igea that she had simon ha'elyon, a simon atachton? L'chura, this is also a simon. In other words, if it's taka only a simon and not a siba, so l'chura, so this is a simon. Simon atachton is a simon. And all simoni elyon is a simon vaday. What do you have to have that all the simoni elyon is a raya that there was a simon atachton? Why can't we just say that the simon elyon itself is a simon? The Teretz says no, because lepeil, in order for it to become a gdela, she has to have simon atachton. And the simon elyon is only a raya that she had simon atachton, and memela, she's taka gdela. I'm saying lechuri, you would be able to bring a raya from here that it's a siba. Maybe you don't bring a raya. Vaiter. Halacha tes. Habas shiyolda achad shtei mesishana. Aval pishal yivya simon le'elyon v'le'tach narizu gdeil. Kos bonim arim kesimon. This is all the yunim, if she has a simon or not, is only if she wasn't yolda. But once she was yolda, so even if she has no simon elyon and no simon tachton, so the bonim itself, there's simon. That's atkan, we spoke about Abbas. So we spoke about Abbas ktana. Then we spoke about a simonim and how she becomes an islandess vaday, how she becomes an islandess, either before, let's say, the earliest she can become an islandess is when she's a month before 20 years old. And bepashto, she has to have the kol simon, the islandess, in order for it to be considered an islandess. And if she doesn't have the simon, the islandess, and she doesn't have simonim, so once she reaches 35 years old and a day, let's say, the 35th birthday, so then she's considered an islandess, even though she has no simoni islandess. As long as she has no simoni, that's benigea an islandess. And al derev ze benigea to become a gdela, we learned that the simon atachton is a simon after she's shtei mesishana. And if she has all the simoni elyon, we assume that she had a simon atachton. And if she has one of the simoni elyon, so then it's a suffix, and therefore she's a suffix gdela suffix tan. Halachi yut. Now we talk about a ben. Mishi yivolit, ad shiyir ben shleisha sishona is nikkur cotton, v'nikkur tinnik. V'afilo hevi kamasayis b'teichz man zeh, eini simen elishuma. Like we said, b'negeh, a bas, but over there it's 12 years, no, it's 13 years. Hevi shteisayis lamata b'mkemes hayiduis l'seir, v'humi ben shleisha sishona v'yemachad v'mayla, so then is nikkur godol v'nikkur ish. Higiel is manzev lehevish teisaris is aval pishin niru be simoni soris. is Hareza Kotan. He can't be considered a Saris at that age. Ad Shiyah ben Esim Shana Pachash Leishinya. He Yir Lizman Ze Vilehevi Shte Saris Lamata. And also Vilehevi Shte Saris Bazokon. So he doesn't have Shte Saris Lamata. And he doesn't have Shte Saris Bazokon. So here Im Nirabe Echad Misimon is Saris. This is already Hareza Saris. And Vidine Din Hagodl Choldov. So Pashat Loshon Aram comes out that if he has no simoni simtach, and he also has no Cyrus in the Zokar, and tzu der tzu, he has one simon, misimoni soris, which we'll say later. So then, is areza soris, v'dine din agadol choldover. So the Raivad asks that l'chura, one of the simoni soris, is only Zokar. So this person has no Zokar, because lehevish de Cyrus bezokar, so he has no Zokar. So l'chura, why are we looking for another simon? Because if one simon of simoni saris is enough, so l'churi, he has no saris lamata, and he has no saris bezokin, so that's a simon. So Mameli says, that's already, you could declare him into a saris at that point in time. That's what the Raivad is asking, and that's what he's telling you, that you could declare him, because if he has no simon lamata, and he has no saris bezokin, so he's already a saris at that point in time. But the Rambam is saying not like that. The Rambam is saying that the fact that he has no saris bezokin, he's not yet a saris. He has to also have echad misimani soris besides that. It's not enough lehevish de sairis bezok. Okay. Then he says, ve'im le nirebe simen misimani soris, nor zitake doesn't have simonim lamata. He doesn't have sairis bezokin. Abu lepeil, he doesn't have shtei sairis bezokin. But he doesn't have any simen misimani soris. Is adayin kotnu. Achi yovish de sairis lamata b'mokum aroylem. And then, even if he has no simonim, but as long as he didn't bring Shtei Cyrus, he'll be considered a Saris. He does have Shtei Cyrus Bezokin. Is Afal P Shinoidly Echad Misimoni Soris? He has Simoni Soris, but he has also Shte Siris Bezokan, Eni Soris. Ella Hareu Bikatnuse, Achi Voldele Kol Simoni Soris, Achiye Be Chomish Ushleish Mishan of Yemechot. So, in order for Nachamal, he was Igielishnas Esser, and he doesn't have Shte Siris, Lamata, but he does have Shte Siris Bezokan. So, if he has Shte Siris Bezokan, so in order for him to be considered a Saris, he has to have Kol Simoni Saris. Now the question is, the Frekt also derived, that L'chura, one of the Simoni Saris, he has no Zokin. If he has Shtei Saris B'Zokin, how could he bring Kol Simoni Saris? So to answer this Rambam, Farshim explained that the Simoni Saris is not, if he has a few Saris B'Zokin, that's still called Simoni Saris. In other words, Ainly Zokin, that our Simoni Soris means he doesn't have a proper Zokin. He doesn't have a proper Zokin. So Kibir Hechatimtsa, that he has Shte Siris B'Zokin, but still he's Ainly Zokin. So there's like an extra din. Knows if he has Shte Siris B'Zokin, in order for him to be considered a Soris, he has to have Kol Simoni Soris. What are Kol Simoni Soris? One of them is that he has no Zokin. But he doesn't have a proper zakon, and so there too he has the other simoni saris, which we'll learn the other eight simoni saris. Masha'inkin, if he has no saris bezakon, so then if he'll have one simon saris, now okay, he still have the kasha, the lechura, he has no saris bezakon, that's itself a simon. But vice versa, you have another simon of saris besides the fact that he has no zakon, so then he's considered a saris according to the Rambam. Yeah. Nachamol, he gear lishnas esim pachish leishim yem, v'lei hevish de sairis lamata, abe v'hevish de sairis bezokan. So then, it's not enough that he has one of simoni saris. Avol pishaneilud le'echad misimoni saris, abe eini saris el areil b'ketnusei achi yevoldo le'kol simoni saris, ei achi yev ben chamish u'shleish mishanav yemachon. So again, the nekudas hadvarim is that if he brings Simonim, so obviously he's a godl, a simon atachni, he's a godl. If he doesn't bring Simonim, and he reaches a month before 20, So if he has no Sairis Lamata and he has no Sairis Bezokan, so then one Sin Soros is enough. Mashainkin, if he does have Shtei Sairis Bezokan, so then he needs Kol Simoni Soros in order to be cleared the Soros. If he doesn't bring that, so then he'll have to wait till he's 35 years old, and then he's considered a Soros even without Simon.
Halacha Yud Gimel, Ve'elo Hein Simoni Soros. Kol She'en Li Zokin, he has no beard. U'sa'ari Lokoi, his hair is like shvache hair, it's like not regular hair, it's weak hair. U'psa'ari Machlik, and his flesh is very smooth, he doesn't have the hair growing on his flesh, on his body. Ve'en Me'mi Raglov Ma'ilim Nesicha, and his Me'raglayim don't create vapor, there's no heat. U'kshamatul Mayim Eina Ese Kippa, when he's matl meiraglayim, there's no arc, it doesn't go far, it just drips down. V'shichva zari deya, in other words, there's no thickness to it, it's like diluted. V'ein meim, it's not like attached to each other. V'ein meim miraglov machmitzim, the meiraglayim don't ferment. And v'rechetz b'meisak sham and v'ein psori maila hevel. And when he washes himself during the winter, and he's washing with warm water, and there's no vapor coming from his flesh, from his sorry, aim sorry, myla hevel. And also, vikeli lokui, and therefore, vein nikr ben ishli isha. These are the simonim of a soros. These are the simonim of a soros. The soros there, who are nikr srischama b'cholmokim. What does it mean, srischama? A soros that as soon as he was rei sachama, he was a soros. In other words, he's a soros because that's how he was born. He was born as a soros. Aval haben shechotchu einitku, emiachu gidov, ebeitzov, kemesha goy noisim. So notice they took away the gid or the beitzim, and as a result of that, he doesn't develop normally the natural way that he would have developed. Had they have not done it, he didn't develop, and therefore all these things happen. Is hun hanikra srisada. And memela, such a person, ukshiyeh ben shleisha sishana v'yemechot, is nikra gadol. So he's considered a gadol, and even though he, because Einzer may be simuloilam, and Memela, so you can't wait for Simonim, there's no Simonim to wait for. And Memela, he's considered a gadol right away. He's considered a gadol right away. Now, the Mice is from here, they bring a Raya Faker. We said before Raya that Simonim makes something happen. Mashenken over here, Lechura, the Reb Chaim brings a Raya, that over here, Lechura ain't a chinami. He you can't bring a ride from the fact that he doesn't have simonim, but Lepele didn't have a simonim. So how does he become a godless? So the teretz is because Be'etzem, simonim is only a simon for godless. So when do you need a simon of godless? A person that would normally bring simonim. But since he doesn't normally bring a simonim, so therefore you don't need this simon. But if the gather of simonim would be that it makes godless, that if simonim makes godless, so he's tiny. So lechur over here, this Lepele is no simonim. So how did he become a gadol? That's a raya, I think Reb Chaim brings, fakert, that a simon makes godless. Fakert, that a simon is only the simon of godless, it doesn't make godless. Because how did it have to make godless? So Lusof Kosov is not making godless. Ben shleisha sishon v'yemechot, shulei hevi sim shulamato, abe veniru be'kola simonim shulamaylo, izareiz a sofik ben gadol lekotn, ben kotn legadol. Ve'im le nivdak mumato, so if we know for a fact that he doesn't have a simon shalamata, then he has the cult, the simonim shalamayla, so then he's a suffix. But if we only know that he has simonim shalamayla, and we don't know for a fact that he does not, he wasn't nivdak, so then we can namon that he's becheskas godl. That's what the Rambam says. The Ma'ase says, the Ravid asks, and Magad Mishnah also asks, the Lechura, where is there a musik called Simonim Shalamaila by a Godel? Before we had Simoni Soris, we had Simoni Soris, we had Simoni Islanders, and by a Baz there was also Simon Elion of Godless. Mashenkin by a band, the Rambam didn't say any Simonim of Godless. He said Simoni Soris. He didn't speak about Simoni Godless. So what's this Ben Shleisha Sishona? That Niru Bekola Simonim Shalomaila, which Simonim, that's what people are asking, is the whole deal. The Gor Pashtus would be that the Simonim Shalomaila means the Simonim, which shows that he's not a Soros. I mean, the Simonim that shows he's not a Soros, but that Lechura, the fact that he's not a Soros, doesn't mean that he's a Godel. I mean, a person could be not a Soros and not be a Godel. He doesn't have
Because the fact that he's not a Saris wouldn't mean that he's a Gadol. He maybe he'll get Saris when he'll be later on. So the question is, what's the Simoni Gadlus? That's Mematr Tzapto. Halacha Tazayin. Shtei Saris or Amuris, Bebenu Bebas, or Bechol Mokim. Can we say that the Simon HaTachton and Shtei Saris is Shiurin, how long do they have to be? Kedei Lokuf Roshon Le'ikron. That the tip of the hair could be folded over and could touch the root of the hair. U'mishayitzmuchu V'yiyu Yecheles Le'in. So that's for sure a Simon. That they could be cut with a scissor. Achi agil lokuf reishon leikram is donalan lahachmer b'chol makim. It's always a suffix because that's a samachlekas in Mishnayis. What's the shear? So the mele lepeil with machmer that even the smaller shear is suffix gadol. Mashenkin to be avadi gadol, it has to be the larger shear. Kedei lokuf reishon leikram lefichok beben ubas. Will be considered them gedolim lahachmer. Lagabi all the dinim of chumra, and also the mechuyev and everything. So therefore, we consider them a katan lahachmer. Now, shtei sairus elu tzricha shiyu bimkeim ha'erva. He said before. He said that it has to be lamata bimkeim as hayiduim. So the mekame is how you do him is be mekame erva, ubeis erva kule mekame simon bein lemaila that says on top of the erva, or bein lemata that says on top of the mekame erva, or bein lemata lower than the mekame erva bein al evri azer atzmon, abu utzriches liyis b'mokim mecha. The shtei sairas have to be in one place. In other words, you can't have one saira on top and one saira on the bottom. On the higher than the Mokim Erva, in one place under the Mokim Erva. It has to be Mokim Echad. And also, that's one Tanai. And Nocha Tanai is V'shiyah B'ikrum Gumis, that they're growing out of a follicle. In other words, if you have a Psasaira that's growing just on the skin, but there's no follicle there, that's not called a proper Saira. And V'afilu Shteim B'gum Achas Arei Elisim. They don't have to have two follicles. They can have one follicle that both Cyrus are growing out of one follicle. Nimtzu shtei gumi zubit tzatzu, and ve'im behem seir, is also a reza simon, because chazoke and gumi b'li seir, memele v'sayrus hoi yibem v'noshu. So if you have one gumis, it could have been one sayra. Mashenken, if you have two gumis, and they're next to each other, so since we have a chazoke that ain't gumi b'li seira, so mele we know that there were two sayras. Halacha Yudches, Habas Shivir Tech Shtei Sairis, Betech Shnas Shtei Mesei, or Vahaben Shehevi Betech Shlei Shesei, Shein Shumak Mishu Biyanu, is Aval P. Shoysen Sairis, Bem Koyman Oimdes, Acha Shlei Shesei Lezocher, Vahacha Shtei Mesei Lenekeva, Enum Simon. So it knows if you saw the Sairis before she became 12 years old, or you saw the Sairis before he became 13 years old, at that point in time, the Sairis weren't a Simon. Now you come back after she's 12 and after he's 13, and you see those Cyrus. So those Cyrus that you saw before she was 12 or before he was 13, at that point in time, it was not considered a simon, and now it's still not a simon. That we say that it's not a simon, and these Cyrus were considered shuma. And as we said, that these Cyrus are shuma, male they're not a simon, they're shuma. They weren't nivduk acher hazman, and v'nimtza shom shtei sairus. And now, after she's already 12 or 13, you find shtei sairus. Is harayim becheska simon ve'neimum shem akedem zman tzomchu kedei shiyu shuma. Because right now you never declared it being shuma, so memele they're considered simonim. It's like a little. It's a hard thing to understand because lepeil mashal. If you see sairus and you see the sairus, there are longer sairus. Obviously, the sairus didn't. You see, he's a ben shlei shesi shana v'yemechot, and you beidik, and you see that he has a saira, and the saira is two sairas that are longer sairas. So mele, obviously it didn't grow today; it grew earlier. So mele, if you would have been beidik him yesterday, you definitely would have seen it, and then it would have been declared the shuma. And then if you would have seen it today, it wouldn't have been a simon. But now, since you didn't see it yesterday, even though today you know that it was here yesterday. Nevertheless, it's considered a simon. You have to understand what's the avonis advar. Halacha chof. Kshaboyitkin habas bein b'teich hazman shu kol shnas shtei mesrei or ben kedem zman ze ben lachrov is boitkin al pinoshim kshedes v'namonis. Va'afilu isha achas bedekes v'shem mimenu mivia mulevia. So in other words, this edus to declare that she has a simna, or the simna is a shuma, all these dinim can be done al pinoshim and also al pishachas. Kol ha'shonim ha'amuris beben u'bas u'be'erchen u'bechol makim. When you say, which you have to know how old the person is, so you have to know if the person is a gadol or a gdela, or what's the shear of the erchen, is einon leishnei alavona. It's not a shnas alavona of yud beis chedesh of a shnas of yud beis chedesh of the alavona, and v'nei shnei achama elishonim shel seder ibur shein pshutes umu ubaris. So you can have a year that's made with 12 months, and you can have a year which is made 13 months. According to the Seder Advarim, how Bezin is Mekadosh L'Kadoshim, that's considered a year. A year is considered like from 1 month, no, it's from a Rish Chedesh Nissan to next year Rish Chedesh Nissan. That's called a month, a year. A year. Whether 13 months elapsed or 12 months. All in Yonim of Yiddishkeit that we deal with how old something is, it goes according to the Chadosh, the Shonim that Bezin came in this. Ain same chanal anoshim b'minyan hashonim. So even though b'negeya the Cyrus you say mechal noshim, but to establish how old she is, that you can't rely on noshim. V'le'a lakrevim. Ela al pi shnei edim k'sherim lahoyd. In order to establish that a person is a certain age, you have to have shnei edim, which k'sherim lahoyd, which means they're an noshim, and they're not craving. So I mean, it's like not so simple to understand how, you know, you want to know if this boy is 12, 13 years old. So how do you know that this boy is 13 years old? So you have to have two Adam Ksherim that say, we know that this boy is 13 years old. How do you know? You remember that this boy was born 13 years ago. It says, this boy, you remember, you saw this boy when he was raised. You remember this boy 13 years ago when he was born. It's not like you just heard that this and these people had a child and the Mele, I mean, and you know that this is considered this child. The pashtus said that this is the child. I mean, is that the pshat? You saw the child. You have to know exactly. I'm not sure how two Adam Ksherim are going to be made that they know that this boy is 13 years old. Yeah. Halacha Chav Gimel. Ha'av she'amar b'ni zeh ben teisha shanav yemechot. Or b'ti zu bas sholish shanav yemechot, which is negea to different halachas. That by Teisha Shanav Yemechot, so Biyasi Biyah, and Aldera Zeh Sholish Shanav, so her Biyah has a Din Biyah, is Neman the Karbon. Lagabi Dini Karbonis, if someone was, knows Lagabi Dini Biyah, which is a Din of Karbon, so that's his Neman. Avalei Lamakas Avalei Lainch. In order to say that, Lamashal, someone that was Bo Albas, that's Sholish Shanav Yemechot, so there could be a Chiyav, there could be a Chiyav Malkas, a Chiyav Misa. So the question is, who says she's bas sholish shanav v'yemechad? The father said she was bas sholish shanav v'yemechad. So legabi that, he's not believed. He's not believed to establish that she's bas sholish shanav v'yemechad, that someone should get malchus or ancient based on that. However, he is neman that someone should have to bring a carbon. In other words, if she was the mashal eishes ish, the person has a daughter and he married her off and she's a bas sholish, and he says she's a bas sholish shanav v'yemechad. And she's an Eishas Ish. So someone that's Bola B'Shegig is Chayiv a Karbon. Someone that's Bola B'Mezid is Chayiv Misa. She's not Chayiv, but he's Chayiv. So the question is, so the father, who says she's Sholosh Shanav Yemecha? The father says Sholosh Shanav Yemecha. So Legabi Karbon, he's believed. And the other person will be Chayiv a Karbon. Masha'inka Legabi, that person should be killed. We have to establish that she's Sholosh Shanav Yemecha. And for that, we're going to need two Eidim Ksheir. That's what it says here. Ha'av she'amar b'ni zeh ben teisha shanav v'yemechot, or b'ti zu bas sholish shanav v'yemechot, is nama l'karbon. L'gabi hilchus karbon, he will be nama. Avalei l'makas v'lei l'enshin. B'ni zeh ben shleish esi shanav v'yemechot, he says he's already 13, or b'ti zu bas shtei masi shanav v'yemechot, is also nama l'nedorim, or l'erchem, or l'charam, or l'hegdeshes, that if they made a neder, or they were mafish erchem, so that's chal. In other words, you have to be machmer, and it's considered a chiyuv. There's a chiyuv nedarim, there's a chiyuv erchim, charamim, hegdash.
Notice that this child should, notice according to what the father is saying, that he's 13 years old or that she's 12. So it comes out that if she'll do an Isur, she'll be Chayv Malkus. Or he'll be Chayv Malkus. So can we give him Malkus based on the testimony of the father about his age? So we say no. Legabi the Chiyuv, that he's Mechuyuv to keep the Nidorim, the Haram, the Erchim, these Dinim. So that he's Mechuyuv. Masha'inka, Legabi, they should get Malkus, an ancient that we don't do. Halacha Chav Dalet. Mi Shiyeshli Avery Zachrus, the Avery Nakfus. Is who are Nikra Dreganus, Vusafik, and Zachrim the Kaver. The Ainley Simon, Shiavadabe, and Musachar Vade in the Kaver Vadois Leila. There's no way of establishing whether he's a Zachar in the Kaver. It's a Suffolk. Misha Ainley, Le Zachrus, Vele Nakvus, Ella Otomu. You can't see, not a Simon Zachrus, not a Simon Nakvus. Is who are Nikra Tumtum, the Gam Husafik. But by a Tumtum, it's possible to be Mavar, the Nikra Tumtum. V'nimtzu zocher, arieku zocher vadi. V'nimtzu nekeva, is arieku nekeva. V'ntumtum v'andregen, shoyi ben shtem esrishon v'yemechot, is arieheim b'cheskas g'delum, v'hein sh'nedaber ben b'chol mokim. So the Rambam says that once they reach shtem esrishon v'yemechot, so then they're b'cheskas g'delum, v'hein sh'nedaber ben b'chol mokim. Whenever we speak about a tumtum v'andregen, you're talking about that when they reach shtem esrishon v'yemechot. So there's two shadows. First of all, that lechura why shtei mesushon of yemechot lechura, I mean there's a suffix zocher suffix nekeva, so lechura letzad that is a zocher lechura should be shleishas yishon of yemechot. That's shaila one. Okay, and then there's another shaila. Why don't we have to look to see if the sire is? That's what the rabbi asks. The rabbi asks v'lomeh becheskes gdelim yivdekum yeshlem simonim lei. So lechura there's a suffix. Why don't you have? Unless you're going to say that they don't bring simonim. They don't bring Simonim. That's Sashayla. Halacha Chavov. Cheresh v'chareshes, who are murim b'chol makim. What is the cheresh and the chareshes, which is discussed many times? Hein ho'ilmim, she'en sheimim v'ein medab. So he's someone that's deaf and dumb. He can't speak and he can't hear. Aval misha medaber v'ein yishemeya, yishemeya v'ein medaber, zareo kcholot, that doesn't have a din, a cheresh has a din of a sheita. Masha'in can so on, that's a medaber v'ein yishemeya, yishemeya v'ein medaber, zareo kcholot. V'ish v'isha, she'in shleimim b'dayton, v'ein on l'charashim v'lisheitim, is nikroin pikach u'pikachas. Is nimtzo, alokha chav zayin, nimtzo kol ha'shem, yishabiyanu inyonu b'shnei prokamelu, esim shemes. This is 20 names. Ve'eluhein, there's Kedushin that we learned in the beginning, Perek Aleph. Then there's Erva, and Shnia, Isur Elavim, Isur Yesa, and that all we learned in Perek Aleph. And then there's a Ktana, and there are Naira, and a Begris, and an Islandus, and a Gdoila, which all of them, a Naira, and a Begris, and an Islandus, were all Gdoila. And there's Simon HaTachten, and there's Simon HaElyon, and there's a Kotna, there's a Srischama, and a Sris Odom, and a Godel, and an Adreganus, and a Tumtum, and a Charoshim, and Pichim. And also, Derech Agav, the Rambam said before that a Sris Odom, so the fact that he doesn't bring Simonim is nothing, and Memele, he's considered a Godel, even without Simonim. Not everyone agrees to this. That's a Machlekes, really. Because the Rambam Namzon, if he's a Sris Chama, so which means that the reason why he didn't bring Simonim was like naturally from him, so then there's a problem. Masha'enken, if he's a Sris Adam, so that's what we assume that he would have brought Simonim. So therefore, it's considered that he's considered a Gadol. But not all the Rishonim agree to that. I'm saying we brought a Raya from that the gather of Simonim, but not all the Rishonim agree to the Rambam. Now, Sim Kol Hashem Yisraelu Lumos Chatamid, Bal Yoluzu Meinecha. They should never go away. Yoluzu Meinecha Kol Yoneim, Kedei Shalinia Tzrichim Levair In Kol Shemiyam, so whenever we'll say this word, you'll know right away.